My lord?
I sent for Selene, not you.
She's defied your orders and fled the mansion, my lord.
Your incompetence is becoming most taxing.
It's not my fault. She's become obsessed. Thinks that I'm at the core of some ridiculous conspiracy.
And here's my proof.
Now I want you to tell them exactly what you told me. No!
All right. For years, we've been trying to combine the bloodlines. And for years, we failed. It was useless. Even at the cellular level, our species seemed destined to destroy each other. Yet the key, we knew, was to locate the rarest of bloodlines. A direct descendant of Alexander Corvinus, Hungarian, a warlord who came to power in the early seasons of the 5th century. Just in time to watch a plague ravage his village. He alone survived.
Somehow, his body was able to change the disease, mold it to his benefit. He became the first true immortal. And years later, he fathered at least 2 children. Who inherited this same trait.
The sons of the Corvinus clan. One bitten by bat, one by wolf, one to walk the lonely road of mortality as a human. It's a ridiculous legend.
Nothing. That may be. But our species do have a common ancestor.
There is a descendant of Corvinus lying there. Not 3 feet from you.
Yes. But he is already a vampire. We needed a pure source. Untainted. An exact duplicate of the original virus. The Corvinus strain itself, which we learned was hidden away in the genetic code of his human descendants and passed along in its dormant form. Down through the ages to Michael Corvin. His blood allows for a perfect union between our species.
There can be no such union. And to speak of it is heresy.
We'll see. Once Lucian has ejected him,
Lucian is dead.
According to whom?